was there?
It was at the bottom of the steps. Dalton and his older brother.
Well, we haven't heard about the older brother yet. Older brother.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else?
The two people that were brought home from the party.
Males or females?
Two males.
Males. Two males. So now we have four males in the apartment.
Yes.
And Rip Van Winkle over here. And his older brother.
Yes.
Doesn't anybody know who Rip Van Winkle was? No idea. Raise your hand if you don't know who Rip Van Winkle was. Just raise your hand. It's almost time to die.
Well, he slept a long time.
Just a second. So, Rip Van Winkle, his older brother, and two other guys.
Yes.
And what happened when he went back? Now at 5:30 in the morning.
She was standing in the yard, and I went into the porch, and Dalton was telling the people to leave, and the one guy was refusing to leave, and I said, no, you're leaving now. Get off my property now. And they started to leave the property. They got around my car. I said, get away from my car. And then one of them turned around to fight me, which facing one-on-one, that's fine. But then the other one came around the back and started sucker punching me in the back of the head. So I'm trying to fight two people off. Well, they stood there and did nothing.
So you have moved to evict them?
Immediately upon
being
assaulted.
That's exactly what you had to do, because two morons that invite a bunch of strangers back to their house drunk at 3 o'clock in the morning, I wouldn't want his tenants living at me upstairs where I live. You understand that, don't you? You do understand that, too. That a moron who invites a bunch of drunks back to her apartment, and as a result of you not being able to control your guests, because you invited a bunch of drunks back with you, he's already slept it off a little bit, all right? Maybe you, I don't know where your older brother is. Where's your older brother?
He's not here.
What do you think? You think I have a vision problem? I have a hearing problem. There's nothing wrong with my eyes. Where is he?
He's not here. He's back home.
What is he doing?
I don't know.
Is he working?
Yeah, he's probably working.
I could have a good time with this, but I'm such a kind person. What was that? That didn't require a smile. I'm a very kind person.
You are.
So when you're a 22-year-old idiot who lives in an apartment where there are other people living, and you invite a bunch of drunks home with you at 3 o'clock in the morning, you're responsible for their actions. And that's what he was complaining about. He said, one of your invited guests assaulted him. That's what he says. And he moved to evict you.
Okay.
Now, we're going to see what you're suing him for. Money owed for return of a deposit and rent.
Yeah.
Strike it off. He didn't buy into getting assaulted by one of your idiot friends. So you don't get a deposit back, and you don't get the rest of your June rent back, or July. By the way, when did you move out?
August 6th.
Did you pay July's rent?
No, because the power was off.
You lived there. Did you pay July's rent?
No.
So forget deposits.
We made a payment, but I said I'm not giving you the rest of the rent because the power was shut off when it was his responsibility to pay our electricity.
He wanted you out. I would have put you out that night. Unfortunately, the law doesn't let him put you out that night, but this man doesn't have to live in a house where he has a bunch of idiots who invite at least five drunks to come back to the house and wreck the joint. He doesn't have to tolerate that. That's you being irresponsible. And you. Do you understand that? Don't you get it? That's being irresponsible. Now, the law, because we have a lot of legal do-gooders floating around here saying, oh, you, because not everybody has a just right to throw you out. They can't throw you out because they don't like that your earrings are too big, they don't like the color green, they don't like whatever. Whatever it is, they don't have every right in the world to throw you out. But they, as far as I'm concerned, in a world that I would govern, if you're making my life a holy hell because of your irresponsibility, it's time to say goodbye, okay? Which is what he did. He went to have you evicted. Good for you. All right. The next thing that you're suing for is your missing laptop. Now, you got notice of eviction on what date?
June 29th.
And when were you supposed to be out?
We talked in person after the eviction.
What date were you supposed to be out?
The eviction notice just was dated. It did not say be out within a certain amount of days.
It says that you moved someplace. Where did you move to with your brother?
My sister's.
Back to your sister?
Yes.
Your poor sister. And on what date did you move back to your poor sister's house?
Same day, August 6th.
How did you get there?
She came and got me.
You too, or had you moved out already?
From where?
You were living with her.
Yeah, we were moved out. I was moved out. Not all of our stuff was moved out, but I was moved out.
Now stand up. No, I can't help it. Sorry, I can't help it. Stand. What date did you move out?
I'm really not too sure, because...
A week before your sister, 2 weeks before your sister. Answer the question.
I was staying with a girlfriend.
Well, I assume that since you can't tell me how long